Good morning, students. Today we are going to study about a new topic called as the bus cycles and basic system components. So what exactly the bus cycle, all those things we are going to see in the today's class. So the main intention of this topic is how many clock cycles a microprocessor is taking to perform a read operation and write operation, and how exactly the multiplexed lines like AD0 to AD15 and the address and the status lines are there now. How exactly those lines are going to be demultiplexed by the microprocessor when it is performing the read-write operations, and what is the signal status when the microprocessor means there are some signals which we have seen during the explanation of the pin diagram like BHE bar and DT slash R bar, DEN bar, RD bar, WR bar. How those signals are going to be means how those signals are going to be utilized by the microprocessor to perform the read-write operation, or other way of explanation is what is the status of those signals when the microprocessor is performing the read-write operation. Okay, now so read-write operation. So all those things we are going to see in the today's class. Now before going to the signal status like this, what you are seeing on the screen. Before going to this, I would like to define few terms. Before going to this explanation, I would like to define few terms which are going to show the time taken by the microprocessor to perform the read operation or the write operation, and to perform the opcode fetch operation, as well as to perform the execution operation. Okay, na? So all those things means all those things are going to be covered. The terms which we are going to define just a few minutes, within few minutes. Okay, na? So here when you are going for concentrating on how exactly the microprocessor is performing the memory read operation or the memory write operation, first of all we should know that what is the time that is taken by the microprocessor to perform a particular read operation and the write operation, and what is the time which is taken by the microprocessor to perform the opcode fetch operation like that. Okay, now. So when you are going for memory read operation, so the microprocessor is literally taking the 4 clock cycles to perform the memory read operation, and in the same way to perform the memory write operation, microprocessor is taking the 4 clock cycles. Microprocessor is taking the 4 clock cycles to perform that particular operation, and we are having the opcode fetch operation. That opcode fetch operation, number of clock cycles that are going to be taken by the microprocessor to execute the opcode fetching operation, that purely depends on the means it is going to be changes the duration, the number of clock cycles for fetching the opcode duration, that clock cycles duration purely depends on the type of the instruction. Some instructions are taking the 6 clock cycles, some instructions are taking the more than six clock cycles. We are not going to a particular instruction, and we are not focusing on that. So we are interested to define what exactly the time taken by the microprocessor to perform the read operation, time taken by the microprocessor to perform the write operation, and time taken by the microprocessor to perform the opcode fetch operation. Okay, now. So here what we'll do is we'll define few terminologies before moving further. Okay, now. So here I would like to focus on few terminologies. One is I would like to define one thing called as a instruction cycle. Instruction cycle, and another scenario called as a bus cycle, or sometimes we call it as a mission cycle. Okay, now bus cycle, or sometimes we call it as a mission cycle. Okay, now. Mission cycle. Okay, sometimes it is called as a mission cycle. Okay, so here, what exactly the instruction cycle, what exactly the bus cycle, we'll define that one. So here, before going to the instruction cycle, let us focus on one instruction. Okay, now, let us focus on one instruction. How exactly that instruction get executed by the microprocessor? Okay, now. So here I'm taking one instruction, simple instruction, which is I would like to take one, the data transfer instruction, move space AL comma 03H. What is the use of this instruction, ma? So as all of knows that it is copying an immediate data into the destination register. It is copying an 8-bit data or the 16-bit data, which is the immediate data copied into the destination. So this is the operation of this particular instruction. Now, when you would like to execute this instruction, we are having the set of instructions, means INT03H, all those things are there, but I'm just focusing on only one instruction. So same thing is going to be applicable for the rest of the instructions which are there in your program. Okay. So when you are having this instruction, and if you want to get execute this instruction, if the microprocessor wants to execute this instruction, what you are supposed to do means you are supposed to evaluate. If you are not having the assemblers, you are supposed to evaluate the opcode for this particular instruction, and that opcode should be saved in the memory. That opcode should be saved in the memory. So my intention is, in order to execute instruction, in order to execute one instruction by the microprocessor, how the microprocessor is performing this operation, how the microprocessor is executing this instruction is a question. I think you would have studied this concept in the 8085 microprocessor, but I would like to revise that concept one more time, because if I would like to define the instruction cycle, then you are supposed to know the complete operation which is performed by the microprocessor to execute one instruction. Okay, so let us suppose this is my microprocessor, this is a MP, that is a microprocessor. And here I am assuming that this is a memory. Okay, it is a memory. So as we know that, in order to execute a program, first we should save that program in the memory, right? So this program, I am assuming that this instruction is stored inside the memory. I'm just taking one instruction now. We are going to have the multiple instructions in the program, obviously. Okay, no? So, but I'm just taking only one instruction in order to explain the concept. Okay, so here I'm assuming that this instruction is stored inside the memory. And as the instruction size is a 2 bytes, because it is an immediate operation, it is going to be occupies the 2 bytes of memory. So means the equivalent opcode for this particular instruction, I'm assuming that the opcode for the mnemonic, from MOV to AL is some XX. I'm just assuming that is the opcode. So it is going to be the XX. Okay. And obviously we are having the immediate data now, which is a 03. Okay. Or otherwise, if you are getting confused with this, you simply remember that we are having the opcode for this particular instruction in the 2 bytes format over here and over here. So when you would like to execute that program, when you would like to execute this particular instruction by the microprocessor, what the microprocessor will do means, first of all, the microprocessor fetches the instruction from the memory into it. After fetching the opcode from the memory into it, as we know that it is performing the decoding operation. Microprocessor is performing the decoding operation. Based on the decoded data, the microprocessor is going to be performs the execution operation. Okay, so means in order to execute one instruction, first of all, that instruction saved in the memory, and the saved information, that is the saved instruction, should be taken from the memory into the microprocessor. That operation is called as a opcode fetch operation. So after fetching the opcode into the microprocessor, inside the microprocessor we are having the decoding block, and that decoding block is going to be decodes your code into the binary format. After that, it will realize what kind of operation need to be performed. Based on that, it is performing the execution operation. Are we clear? So means, in order to execute one instruction, what are the steps which are going to be followed by the microprocessor? Means, step one is, it is fetching the instruction from the memory. And step two is going to be execute the instruction. It is performing the decoding, which is not included over here. Okay, now. So fetching and the execution is a main major topic to define the instruction cycle. So once the opcode is fetched from the memory into the microprocessor, that operation is called as a fetching operation. Execution is nothing but decoding and realizing and performing the operation. That entire thing comes under the execution. So one is a fetching operation, another one is a execution operation. So here, when the microprocessor is fetching the information, that is a opcode related to this particular instruction from the memory into it, it is taking some time. That duration is called as a fetching operation. To perform the fetching operation, it is taking some time. So I'm assuming that for my convenient and for your convenient, I'm assuming that the number of clock cycles which are going to be utilized by the microprocessor to perform the fetching operations are 6 clock cycles. I'm assuming that the duration The means the microprocessor is taking the 6 clock cycles to fetch the instruction from the memory into it and to execute that operation, means to perform that operation. That may be the fetching the instruction from the memory and storing that fetching the instruction from the memory into the microprocessor. After that, we are having the decoding block, the microprocessor realizes what kind of operation need to be performed. For that, it may be that operation may be the read operation or write operation. We are having the memory read operation or memory write operation, I/O read operation or the I/O write operation. So simply I'm assuming it is a memory read operation, means it is taking the 6 clock cycles to perform the fetching operation and to execute the instruction, means to copy the information from the to copy the 03 data into the AL. This is called as a execution. Actual operation is the copying the data into the AL, but this operation is stored inside the memory as a opcode, and that opcode is fetched into the microprocessor. It is decoding that particular opcode and trying to execute that. After decoding that particular opcode, it realizes that it need to copy the 03 data into the AL in simple shot. Okay, so that operation is called as the execution operation. So as we have seen in the previous slide, that I'm assuming that the execution cycle, in order to execute, that is a read operation or write operation or the copy operation, it is going to take the 4 clock cycles. Okay. So here, fetching is nothing but reading the opcode from the memory into the microprocessor. Actually, this operation is called as a fetching operation, but for your convenience, I'm calling it as a reading. Actually, reading the opcode from the memory into the microprocessor is called as a fetching operation. And after the opcode is fetched into the microprocessor, it is going to be get decoded by the decoder block. And after decoding the instruction opcode into the binary format, it realizes what kind of operation need to be performed. Okay, now that operation is going to be done by the microprocessor. That may be the memory read operation, memory write operation, I/O read operation, or I/O write operation. Okay, now means in order to execute one instruction, microprocessor is following through these two steps. It is performing the fetching operation, and it is performing the execution operation. For the fetching operation, I am assuming that it is taking the 6 clock cycles. Again, I am saying that it purely depends on the size of the instruction. Okay, now, but I am just taking the basic size of an instruction. So in that case, the fetching duration is going to be the 6 clock cycle. In order to perform the fetching operation by the microprocessor, it is taking the 6 clock cycles. And in order to execute this operation, after fetching, it is taking the 4 clock cycles. Okay, now. So means it is taking some time to read the information from the memory, that is fetching the opcode from the memory and execute that operation. The time taken by the microprocessor to perform these two operations are called as a instruction cycle. The time taken by the microprocessor to perform fetching and the execution operation is called as a instruction cycle. So instruction cycle is nothing but the time that is taken by the microprocessor to perform the fetching and executing operation is called as an instruction cycle. Remember that one. So the same thing for every instruction, whatever the instructions which are there in your program, every instruction is following these two steps. Okay, now we are having the fetching as well as the execution. Between these, we are having the decoding. We are not considering that. Okay, now the decoding comes under the execution only. So fetching is nothing but fetching the output from the memory, and decoding block and execution block comes under the execution unit only. Okay, now the instruction cycle is nothing but the time that is taken by the microprocessor to fetch the output from the memory and decode it and execute it. That entire time is called as an instruction cycle. Now, let us go for defining the mission cycle. So, if you want to see this one, or I'll come back to this slide. Okay. So, let us go for what the mission cycle, or what is that bus cycle? Bus cycle is nothing but the time taken by the microprocessor to perform the memory read operation or memory write operation or I/O read operation or I/O write operation. Okay, now, whatever the bus related operations which are going to be done by the microprocessor, during that bus related operation, how much time the microprocessor is taking to perform that operation, that duration is called as a bus cycle. Okay, now, so bus cycle, sometimes it is also called as a mission cycle. Okay, instruction cycle is nothing but the time taken by the microprocessor to perform आपको फेचिंग ऑपरेशन एज वेल एज द एक्सिक्यूशन ऑपरेशन इज कॉल्ड एज ए इंस्ट्रक्शन साइकिल एंड बस साइकिल और द मशीन साइकिल इज नथिंग बट द माइक्रो प्रोसेसर दैट द टाइम दैट इज टेकन बाय द माइक्रो प्रोसेसर टू परफॉर्म द मेमोरी रीड ऑपरेशन मेमोरी राइट ऑपरेशन और आईओ रीड ऑपरेशन और आईओ राइट ऑपरेशन सो दैट ड्यूरेशन इज कॉल्ड एज ए बस साइकिल दैट ड्यूरेशन इज कॉल्ड एज ए bus cycle or the machine cycle. Okay, na? So don't get confused with the bus cycle and the instruction cycle. Instruction cycle means to it includes both steps, but bus cycle means it related to the read write operations that may be the memory or IO. Okay, na? That is nothing but the bus cycle. Okay, so now, so the duration is nothing but, as I told you, fetching operation is taking the 6 clock cycles, na? So here from the slide, if you see this one, to perform the read operation, how many clock cycles are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. Microprocessor is taking the 4 clock cycles. Okay, na? So the duration, that duration is called as a bus cycles duration. Okay, na? Or that duration is called as a machine cycle. So how many number of clock cycles that are going to be taken by the microprocessor to perform the read or the write operation? So in the similar format, we are having the opcode fetch operation also. For the opcode fetch operation, we are not having only the 4. We are going to have the 6. Minimum is going to be the 6 and maximum is going to be the 18. Okay, now that purely depends on the size of the instruction. Okay, so I am taking the minimum concept for the opcode fetching. That is nothing but the 6 clock cycles. Means we are going to have one operation called as a opcode fetch. Okay, no? So opcode fetch is taking the 6 clock cycles, but this execution operation is taking the 4 clock cycles. Or in short, if you want to know what exactly the instruction cycle means, you can write like this. Okay, no? Instruction cycle is equals to the fetch cycle plus execution cycle. Instruction cycle is nothing but fetch cycle plus execution cycle. It means the time that is taken by the microprocessor to perform the fetching as well as the execution operation is called as a instruction cycle. Okay. So now let's go for the what is the bus status when the microprocessor is trying to perform the memory read operation. What is the bus status when the microprocessor trying to perform the write operation? Okay. So in order to realize these concepts, what you do is just pass the video and recollect the information which is related to the what exactly the address latch enable, what exactly the M/IO bar signal, what exactly the BHE/S7, and means all the multiplex lines and the multiplex lines from AD0 to AD15, read signal, DT/R bar, that is a data trans receiving signal, and data enable signal, and the write signal. Okay, now just recollect these signal status and we'll see how exactly these signals are going to be changes depending on the type of the operation. So as a power off, what I'm doing is I'm just terminating this video and I'm going to continue the next.